Horrid Henry and the Secret Club by Francesca Simon, read by Miranda Richardson. Horrid Henry's injection. The horrible screams came from behind Nurse Needle's closed door. Horrid Henry looked at his younger brother, Perfect Peter. Perfect Peter looked at Horrid Henry. Then they both looked at their father, who stared straight ahead. Henry and Peter were in Dr. Dettol's waiting room. Moody Margaret was there. So were Sour Susan, Anxious Andrew, Jolly Josh, Weepy William, Tough Toby, Lazy Linda, Clever Claire, Rude Ralph, and just about everyone Henry knew. They were all waiting for the terrible moment when Nurse Needle would call their name. Today was the worst day in the world. Today was Injection Day. Horrid Henry was not afraid of spiders. He was not afraid of spooks. He was not afraid of burglars, bad dreams, squeaky doors, and things that go bump in the night. Only one thing scared him. Just thinking about... Henry could barely even say the word. Injections? Made him shiver and quiver and shake and quake. Nurse Needle came into the waiting room. Henry held his breath.
Please let it be someone else, he prayed.
William, said Nurse Needle. Weepy William burst into tears. Let's have none of that, said Nurse Needle. She took him firmly by the arm and closed the door behind him.
I don't need an injection, said Henry. I feel fine.
Injections stop you getting ill, said Dad. Injections fight germs.
But I don't believe in germs, said Henry.
I do, said Dad.
I do, said Peter.
Well, I don't, said Henry.
Dad sighed. You're having an injection and that's that.
I don't mind injections, said Perfect Peter. I know how good they are for me.
Horrid Henry pretended he was an alien who'd come from outer space to jab Earthlings.
Ow!
Shrieked Peter.
Don't be horrid, Henry! Shouted Dad.
Ah!
Came the terrible screams from behind Nurse Needle's door.
Ah! No!
Then Weepy William staggered out, clutching his arm and wailing.
Cry, baby, said Henry.
Just wait, Henry,
sobbed William. Nurse Needle came into the waiting room. Henry closed his eyes.
Don't pick me,
he begged silently. Don't pick me.
Susan, said Nurse Needle.
Sour Susan crept into Nurse Needle's office.
Ah!
Came the terrible screams.
Ah! No!
Then Sour Susan dragged herself out, clutching her arm and snivelling.
What a crybaby, said Henry.
Well, we all know about you, Henry, said Susan sourly.
Oh, yeah, said Henry. You don't know anything.
Nurse Needle reappeared.
Henry hid his face behind his hands. I'll be so good if it's not me, he thought. Please let it be someone else.
Margaret,
said Nurse Needle.
Henry relaxed.
Hey, Margaret, did you know the needles are so big and sharp they can go right through your arm? Said Henry.
Moody Margaret ignored him and marched into Nurse Needle's office. Henry could hardly wait for her terrible screams. Boy, would he tease that crybaby Margaret. Silence. Then Moody Margaret swaggered into the waiting room, proudly displaying an enormous plaster on her arm. She smiled at Henry.
Oh, Henry, you won't believe the needle she's using today, said Margaret. It's as long as my leg.
Shut up, Margaret, said Henry. He was breathing very fast and felt faint.
Anything wrong, Henry? Asked Margaret sweetly.
No, said Henry. He scowled at her. How dare she not scream and cry?
Oh, good, said Margaret. I just wanted to warn you because I've never seen such big, fat, whopping needles in all my life.
Horrid Henry steadied himself. Today would be different. He would be brave. He would be fearless. He would march into Nurse Needle's office, offer his arm, and dare her to do her worst. Yes, today was the day. Brave Henry, he would be called. The boy who laughed when the needle went in. The boy who asked for a second injection. The boy who...
Henry, said Nurse Needle.
No, shrieked Henry. Please, please, no.
Yes, said Nurse Needle. It's your turn now.
Henry forgot he was brave. Henry forgot he was fearless. Henry forgot everyone was watching him. Henry started screaming and screeching and kicking.
Ow!
Yelped Dad.
Ow!
Yelped Perfect Peter.
Ow!
Yelped Lazy Linda. Then everyone started screaming and screeching.
I don't want an injection!
Shrieked Horrid Henry.
I don't want an injection!
Shrieked Anxious Andrew.
I don't want an injection!
Shrieked Tough Toby.
Stop it! Said Nurse Needle. You need an injection, and an injection is what you will get.
Him first!
Screamed Henry, pointing at Peter.
You're such a baby, Henry, said Clever Claire.
That did it. No one ever called Henry a baby and lived. He kicked Claire as hard as he could. Claire screamed.
Ah!
Nurse Needle and Dad each grabbed one of Henry's arms and dragged him howling into her office. Peter followed behind, whistling softly. Henry wriggled free and dashed out. Dad nabbed him and brought him back. Nurse Needle's door clanged shut behind them. Henry stood in the corner. He was trapped. Nurse Needle kept her distance. Nurse Needle knew Henry. Last time he'd had an injection, he kicked her. Dr. Dettol came in.
What's the trouble, nurse? She asked.
Him, said Nurse Needle. He doesn't want an injection.
Dr. Dettol kept her distance. Dr. Dettol knew Henry. Last time he'd had an injection, he'd bitten her.
Take a seat, Henry, said Dr. Dettol.
Henry collapsed in a chair. There was no escape.
What a fuss over a little thing like an injection, said Dr. Dettol.
Call me if you need me, she added, and left the room.
Henry sat on the chair, breathing hard. He tried not to look as Nurse Needle examined her gigantic pile of syringes. But he could not stop himself peeking through his fingers. He watched as she got the injection ready, choosing the longest, sharpest, most wicked needle Henry had ever seen. Then Nurse Needle approached, weapon in hand.
Him first!
Shrieked Henry. Perfect Peter sat down and rolled up his sleeve.
I'll go first, said Peter. I don't mind. Oh,
he said, as he was jabbed.
That was perfect, said Nurse Needle.
What a good boy you are, said Dad.
Perfect Peter smiled proudly. Nurse Needle rearmed herself.
Horrid Henry shrank back in the chair. He looked around wildly. Then Henry noticed the row of little medicine bottles lined up on the counter. Nurse Needle was filling her injections from them. Henry looked closer. The labels read, "Do not give injection if a child is feverish or seems ill."
Nurse Needle came closer, brandishing the injection.
Henry coughed.
And closer.
Henry sneezed. And closer.
Henry wheezed and rasped and panted.
Nurse Needle lowered her arm.
"Are you all right, Henry?"
"No," gasped Henry. "I'm ill. My chest hurts. My head hurts. My throat hurts."
Nurse Needle felt his sweaty forehead. Henry coughed again, a dreadful, throaty cough.
"I can't breathe," he choked. "Asthma."
"You don't have asthma, Henry," said Dad.
"I do too,"
said Henry, gasping for breath.
Nurse Needle frowned.
"He is a little warm," she said.
"I'm ill,"
whispered Henry pathetically.
"I feel terrible."
Nurse Needle put down her syringe.
"I think you'd better bring him back when he's feeling better," she said.
"All right," said Dad. He'd make sure Henry's mother brought him next time.
Henry wheezed and sneezed, moaned and groaned all the way home. His parents put him straight to bed.
"Oh, Mum,"
said Henry, trying to sound as weak as possible.
"Could you bring me some chocolate ice cream to soothe my throat? It really hurts."
"Of course,"
said Mum.
"You poor boy."
Henry snuggled down in the cool sheets.
Ah, this was the life.
"Oh, Mum,"
added Henry, coughing.
Could you bring up the TV? Just in case my head stops hurting long enough for me to watch."
"Of course," said Mum.
"Boy, this was great," thought Henry. "No injection, no school tomorrow, supper in bed."
There was a knock on the door.
It must be Mum with his ice cream.
Henry sat up in bed, then remembered he was ill. He lay back and closed his eyes.
"Come in, Mum," said Henry hoarsely.
"Hello, Henry." Henry opened his eyes. It wasn't Mum.
It was Dr. Dettol. Henry closed his eyes and had a terrible coughing fit.
"What hurts?" said Dr. Dettol.
"Everything," said Henry. "My head, my throat, my chest, my eyes, my ears, my back and my legs."
"Oh, dear," said Dr. Dettol. She took out her stethoscope and listened to Henry's chest. "All clear." She stuck a little stick in his mouth and told him to say,
"Ah."
"All clear." She examined his eyes and ears, his back and his legs. Everything seemed fine.
"Well, Doctor," said Mum.
Dr. Dettol shook her head. She looked grave. "He's very ill," said Dr. Dettol.
"There's only one cure."
"What?" said Mum.
"What?"
said Dad.
"An injection."
We'll be right back.
Horrid Henry and the Secret Club. Halt! Who goes there?
Me.
Who's me? Said Moody Margaret.
Me,
said Sour Susan.
What's the password?
Sour Susan paused. What was the password? She thought and thought and thought.
Potatoes?
Margaret sighed loudly. Why was she friends with such a stupid person?
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is, said Susan.
Potatoes was last week's password, said Margaret.
No, it wasn't.
Yes, it was, said Moody Margaret. It's my club, and I decide.
There was a long pause.
All right, said Susan sourly. What is the password?
I don't know if I'm going to tell you, said Margaret. I could be giving away a big secret to the enemy.
But I'm not the enemy, said Susan. I'm Susan.
Shh, said Margaret.
We don't want Henry to find out who's in the secret club.
Susan looked quickly over her shoulder. The enemy was nowhere to be seen. She whistled twice.
All clear, said Sour Susan. Now let me in.
Moody Margaret thought for a moment. Letting someone in without the password broke the first club rule.
Prove to me you're Susan and not the enemy pretending to be Susan, said Margaret.
You know it's me, wailed Susan. Prove it.
Susan stuck her foot into the tent.
I'm wearing the black patent leather shoes with the blue...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.